Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. With our main topic today, we're discussing the development in Upper Egypt Governorates, and President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is giving very good care and directives to improve and develop Upper Egypt Governorates. In light of this, the Sadat Academy have held a summit in order to discuss developing and providing help for Upper Egypt Governorates. To shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to host this morning in the Breakfast Show Dr. Naveen Makram, the professor of and head of computer science department in Sadat Academy. Good morning, Dr. Makram.
Good morning.
Dr. Makram, now as we all know that President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is giving very good care for the Upper Egypt Governorates, and especially that the Decent Life Initiative have already started. It's going to take 3 years to be implemented or finished, but it started with Upper Egypt.
Yes.
So could you give us your insight concerning what is facing Upper Egypt, and why did the president chose that Decent Life starts with Upper Egypt?
Actually, President Fattah al-Sisi is really focusing on the development of Upper Egypt, and this has been very obvious, for example, like with the initiative of Decent Life, because they're targeted 89% of the funds to Upper Egypt villages. The first phase deals with 334 villages, and it's focusing on making lives there better through education, through providing schools, through, for example, providing or creating new jobs there. Because, for example, we have like 21% of the population, talking about the youth, 18 years to 29 years.
Yes.
So all of the initiatives, like, for example, Takaful and Karama program.
Yes, or solidarity and dignity.
Yes, or Decent Life initiatives.
Yes.
They're targeting Upper Egypt. It's very important, and it's number one priority in these initiatives.
Yes. Yes. So concerning the summit that is held under the auspices of the Sadat Academy in order to improve and provide help for the Upper Egypt Governorate, and it started with Menia Governorate. Could you give us an idea about this?
It will be held by the end of October.
Yes.
In the branch of Menia, because we have seven branches in Sadat Academy, and it's under the auspices of the new president of the Academy, Professor Muhammad Hassan Abdel Azim.
Yes.
We were thinking about how to be there, how to help the students and the fresh graduates. So we thought about this first summit, and there will be another two summits, inshallah, next year.
Yes.
We're focusing on five governorates right now, and we'll be starting with Menia, since we have a very
good
branch.
So why did you choose Menia?
Because we have a very good branch there, so we
yes.
have staff, and it's ready to accommodate the summit. And we thought about inviting different ministries to join with us. We need to shed more light on the business opportunities and the training opportunities for the youth, whether they're students or post-grad students or fresh graduates.
Yes.
So we need to shed more light on these opportunities. They're not aware of many of the initiatives held there or even held in Cairo through different ministries like
yes.
the Ministry of Planning or the Ministry of Telecommunications.
Yes. So who is helping in this initiative that is raised by the Sadat Academy? Are they the students in the university, the doctors, the professors?
Actually, we will cooperate with the Sanad initiative. That's an initiative, again, focusing on the development of Upper Egypt students and youth.
Yes.
So we had kind of two or three meetings with them, and we will target other ministries. As for the team who will be responsible for this event, I'm the leader of this team, and we have students, we have other doctors, and we have two TAs to help us, especially with the e-marketing of the event.
Yes, yes. So what is the kind of coordination that takes place between the initiative raised by, or this summit by Sadat Academy and the initiative of Decent Life? Are there any coordination?
No, we're coordinating with another initiative, with Sanad, because Sanad
yes.
is focusing on Upper Egypt youth. And they started
So can
with
we
us.
Say that it's going parallel to the Decent Life initiative?
Actually, it will go in parallel because it's the same vision. We're actually helping to accomplish the vision of our president.
Yes.
Because all of the initiatives are targeting youth, are targeting Upper Egypt, and are targeting how to provide better life. Better life will never be available unless you have better education and better job opportunities.
Yes.
So we need to educate the students, and we need to make them ready to enable them to join the market. That's what's lacking there.
What are the kind of training that you provide for the participants in this initiative raised by Sadat Academy?
We'll be focusing on the IT.
Yes.
Could you the information technology, whether we're talking about basics of information technology or the artificial intelligence.
Yes.
And we need to explain to them what is digital transformation, what about digitizing, what about digitalization, these new terms, what about the smart cities, new smart cities, in order to make them ready for the local and the international markets.
Yes, yes. So do you choose or select specific students and specific doctors, or everybody participates in this initiative?
Now we'll have kind of an interview with the students and the fresh graduates who will apply, because we'll have only 120 to 150 students,
so
or
a limited number.
Yes.
Yes.
Because of what the social distancing.
Yes. What, doctor, what is the criteria by which you choose the students participating in this initiative?
Students who will be kind of interested to attend the training afterwards, and they need to have some basics. You know, we have some tests for them, like for example, for the common sense, for the general knowledge.
Yes.
And then we will educate them, especially in the field of information technology. This will be done through 3 weeks. We'll start with the basics, and then the intermediate level, and then some advanced topics.
Yes. How would the students and the youth in the Sadat Academy would benefit from this initiative? Would this prepare them in order in the future to participate in the social help and services, and also to prepare them for the labor market?
Actually, I talked to my team there, the Enactus team. That's one of the student activities in all of the universities in Egypt. And they will be organizing this event. This raises their sense of belonging, whether to the academy or to the country. And it shows them that they will have, inshallah, a better future.
Yes.
So we need to make them kind of a partner with us. They will be doing the database for the students who will join, the ushering, and many of the tasks. And they're very happy and proud that they will be organizing this event with us.
Yes, yes. Is this the first time that the summit is held?
Yes.
How many days would it take?
We will start by one day, just kind of an introduction with them, and we'll be having 3 sessions in order to shed more light on all of the initiatives, the opportunities, whether in Egypt or out of Egypt, okay, because we might connect them with other universities as well in order to get the training online.
Yes.
And then after this, we will do kind of an assessment, and we'll prepare them for the 3 weeks program.
Yes.
Of information technology.
Doctor, do you think that one day is enough to discuss everything?
One day, one long day, just for the awareness part.
Yes.
But for the training, at least the 3 weeks.
Yes.
We will start.
So the training is going to take 3 weeks.
Yes.
So how long would this initiative take concerning in Mania, for example, governorate, the first governorate you start with?
We will start by these 3 weeks, and then it's kind of a pilot stage or pilot program, and then we'll go for the other governorates. But we thought about Mania, since we have all of the facilities there, and it's kind of a big governorate to start with.
Yes. So how long would this program take, or this summit cover the Mania governorate? Is it going to spend months or 1 year? Or
after the 3 weeks, we'll do kind of an
evaluation
and assessment for the whole thing. Yes, for the summit and for the training as well, because that it might not be what they're looking for. But we thought about at least doing kind of a computer literacy for them, because they need to be aware. They need to understand the terms. Whenever we start any IT course nowadays in our academy, we try to make them more aware, all of the students in the 4 years in our faculty, because they cannot be graduates or even students in kind of a good academy and not knowing what's going on in their country.
Yes.
So explain to them what is sustainable development, what about Egypt 2030, what is their role in fulfilling this, and we give them kind of the future jobs.
Yes.
In order to make them ready for it.
Yes. So how do you see this initiative as it's going to be a role model for all universities and colleges in Egypt, providing help for certain given rates in Egypt by the help of the university students?
Actually, we started because Sadat Academy was always the leader in this part, to train the students, to train the fresh graduates, and to enable them for the market. So we'll be starting this summit, and we hope that other universities will join later on.
How would the field of IT help participants and students to help in this initiative?
Okay, they will not be able to join any good company, okay, whether in Egypt or out of Egypt, if they're not at least computer literate, if they're not aware of the basics. So we need to educate them, because there is no job nowadays without IT.
Yes.
Especially with the corona.
Could you give us a closer look? How would the IT help in this initiative? An example.
Help the students?
Yes.
Okay, it will help them to be more educated and ready for the market. And then they will be able to join and to have the new job opportunities.
Yes.
Like for example, we said that many of the jobs will disappear, maybe 5,000 jobs. That's a study that was done with the jobs, and whether the IT will raise the unemployment. But we found out that it will not raise the unemployment. Although we have 5,000 jobs niche, but we'll create more than 30,000 other jobs.
Yes.
So we need to educate our youth again and to make them ready for this market. They cannot go and join any good company without being computer literate and without having at least an idea about what artificial intelligence and digital transformation is.
Yes, yes. So only students from Sadat Academy are participating in this? No coordination between, for example, Sadat Academy and other universities?
No, Sadat Academy is organizing the event.
Yes.
But we're welcoming any students.
The participation of
joining of selection, any? Yeah, this selection will be done by Sanad Initiative.
Yes.
They will select the students, but we are organizing the event as a start. That's the first summit, and we're hoping to have the second summit very soon, maybe in January or February.
Yes. Doctor, what are the ministries that are coordinating or providing help in this initiative by Sadat Academy?
I cannot tell you the final say.
But you're still
choosing? Yes, we're inviting many ministries, but we're still waiting for their formal approval. Okay.
Yes. For example, the Social Solidarity?
The Ministry of Youth.
Yes.
We will target the Ministry of Planning as well, the Ministry of Education. Yes. So we'll be targeting, and or actually we sent some invitations to the ministries, but we're waiting for them a formal approval.
Yes. So, and all the professors are participating also in this initiative? The teachers, I mean.
Not really.
No. Targeting so you choose students. Also the teachers or the professors who are going to participate in this?
We will invite all of them.
Yes.
But we're only a small team who will organize the event, but they're most welcome to attend. It will add. That's a very valuable asset.
Yes. So you're starting with the Minya Governorate. What are other governorates that you are planning to implement this initiative?
I think next time it will be Asyut, but we're waiting.
How do you choose the governorate?
Again, it's with the Sanad Initiative.
Yes.
They're having kind of an idea where are the most of the students
the most
who need
needy.
This training.
Yes. Yes.
We need to satisfy the needs of these people to go there and to provide. Even we thought about our president in the academy, thought about providing all of the training there.
Yes.
In order to make it much easier for the students coming from Upper Egypt. Instead of bringing them to Cairo branch, it will be more convenient for them to join there the 3 weeks. And we're kind of talking to other companies, either IT companies, multinational, so that they can provide the training there in Minya branch.
Yes, yes. So, Doctor, do you think that there are, for example, NGOs or private sector that could help or participate in this initiative by Sadat Academy?
This time we're focusing on the participation of ministries.
Yes.
And initiatives, maybe later on. You know, that's the first summit for us to be held there in Minya. So we need, again, to assess the performance and assess the outcomes once it's finished.
Yes.
Once we finish with the summit and with the 3 weeks, I guess we'll have better opportunities maybe next time.
Yes. Doctor, the budget for this project or this initiative, yes, how can you, do you afford this?
It's covered by Sadat Academy.
Yes.
Because we'll be kind of volunteering and we're helping or we're inviting other companies again to volunteer to give this training.
Yes.
So it will be covered by us, by SAMHSA.
Yes, it would leave a great echo, of course, and help the society by all means, of course.
Yes, we hope
and
so.
And it would provide the experience and the students would benefit and would be prepared to serve their country when they,
felt,
are graduated.
You know, that's how to raise the sense of belonging of the students, that they're helping other people. And again, that they're ready, that our faculty is making them ready for the market, because that's a main complaint in Cairo or in Egypt, maybe, that once they graduate, they cannot find jobs without having more training.
Yes.
So we thought about this gap, how to fill the gap.
Yes.
They're very good students, they're very good graduate students, but we need to enable them, to make them ready for the market, without needing to take more training on their own once they finish.
Yes. So finally, we'd like that you talk to us quickly about the Decent Life Initiative, its importance. It's going to take 3 years and it's going to help around 53 million people in Egypt.
Yes, and we started with the first phase covering 334 villages till now out of the 375 villages targeted. And again, they're focusing on providing better education through schools, better schools in these areas, and better job opportunities, and about giving kind of finance to those who could start small or minor projects, you know, with the SMEs, the small or medium enterprises. So that's the mentality there, how to make them better through educating them, and through helping them to start their own companies, their own work. And I guess it's very convenient right now, especially with the coronavirus, because they can do this from home. They can start their own business from home. It's much easier and it costs less.
Yes. Well, I thank you very much for your valuable information and for coming today. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
Thank you. It's my pleasure. It's my pleasure. I have the honor to host you, Dr. Naveen Makram, a professor and head of the computer science department in Sadat Academy. Best of luck.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for following me. I leave you with other segments coming up next in the Breakfast Show with my colleague Shireen Aydin.